I think Roberto Duran became the personification of all our fears to achieve greatness, to all our doubts about what we can really do internationally, competing with the best. He became the catalyst for a national awareness of our capacities. And in that sense, Duran became a hope, you know, for everybody. His success reflected the possibility of success of the whole country, because he not only was champion, he stayed champion, and he created a benchmark for international fighters all over the world of what class and stamina and will and sheer power could do. Duran was merchandise for these people. They saw him not as a human being, they saw him as a boxer who can create this amount of wealth. Not just for himself, for me too. And it's very likely that Roberto Duran, in his mind, said, you know, this is not what I want to do. This is not what's important to me. It's important to you, but it's not important to me. He had an existential crisis on the ring. And one may call it a panic attack, or one may call it a breakdown of sorts, or an epiphany, where he said, I don't want to do this anymore. And he left in the middle of it. Never happened before. Never happened before, and I think it never happened since. But then that shows you also how unique Duran is. Edgar is as solid an actor as I've seen. I mean, I saw him in Carlos. I saw an actor that could manage to work in five languages, that could portray and hold the interest in a tough role. To work with him is wonderful. And he's solid can be in this fight. He's working very, 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 very hard. He got himself in shape. I mean, I've seen him work. I mean, this is tough, tough going. Four different fights. Four different fights in different weights, different times. It's very hard. Usher surprised the heck out of me. How well prepared he is, how good he is, how serious he is, how focused he is, got himself in shape. And the stuff that Usher and Roberto were doing, it looked like a fight. I mean, it was not, I didn't have the impression that I was seeing something staged or choreographed. Intelligence is the art of reading between the lines. And he picks people, intelligent people, to work in the film. The intelligent people will recognize an intelligent person and will trust the intelligent person. In this case, the director. So De Niro trusts him. He's not gonna come with just some guy, not gonna do that. In Panama, you can find locations for anything because of the over 100 years presence of the United States here. You have a lot of settings that are from the 50s and the 40s and the 30s. And then you have the Spanish, who were here in the 17th century, so you have Spanish settings. And beaches in Cunayala, with the water as white as you would find in Polynesia. You can do westerns here, you can do international intrigue, you can do war, you can do anything you want.
Die Hard originated from the failed script of Commando 2. For this and more movie facts, click on more videos. But if you want something else, click on the playlist.